Hey, hey, fellow scientists, Justin here again, and welcome to my brand new cooking show! Ooh. Just kidding, no one thought it was a good idea for me to go near an oven. Nevertheless, baking is a great way to find out more about how matter can change. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to define physical and chemical changes in matter and tell the difference between the two. Let's get into it. Matter is constantly changing around us. Anytime you fold a paper airplane, chew a stick of bubblegum, or light a candle, you are causing matter to change. We can split all the different ways that matter can change into two different categories: physical changes and chemical changes. A physical change is a change to matter in which its form changes, but not its identity. When a physical change happens, no new substances are formed. For example, I can carefully cut this piece of paper, and I've changed it. I've changed the form, but it's all still paper. Nothing new was made. It's the same as if I fold this paper, or rip it, or crumple it up and toss it. Man, I gotta stop throwing things here. Another great example of a physical change is a state change of matter. Water can freeze, melt, evaporate, condense over and over again, but it'll still be water. In a state change, no new substances are made, and so it is a physical change. What other kinds of physical changes can you come up with? Pause the video here and write down your thoughts in your guided notes. Remember, a physical change is any change where the form changes, but not the identity of the matter. No new substances are made. Some physical changes are reversible, meaning that they can be undone. Water that's frozen can melt again. Paper that's folded can be unfolded. However, not all physical changes are reversible. I mean, you can't really put a log back together after you've already chopped it in half. But some physical changes are, and that is a huge distinction between physical changes and chemical changes. A chemical change is a change that happens when different matter meets to turn into new substances. When a chemical change happens, the identity of the matter itself changes. We've already seen some examples of chemical changes back in our last lesson when we learned about chemical properties. After all, a chemical change is what needs to happen in order to be able to observe a chemical property. Explosions, rust, and burning are all examples of chemical changes. There are actually a few things that we can look out for in order to tell whether or not a chemical change has happened. For instance, the matter itself could change color. That's what happens with rust, right? It could also produce an odor, which is a smell. It could absorb or release heat. It could produce bubbles or gas. And it could also produce light or sound. Burning is a great example of a chemical change. Let's take a close look at these logs burning and look for the signs of a chemical change. As they burn, the logs emit light and heat. They're also releasing a gas in the form of smoke, and if you were standing next to them, you'd probably also notice a burning smell. All of these are signs of a chemical change. Most importantly, a new substance is being produced, ash. What signs of a chemical change can we see with an orange as it rots? The fruit will begin to change color, a sign of a chemical change, and you would probably notice an odor that wasn't there before. Looking at rust, burning logs, and rotting fruit, you might begin to notice that all of these changes are irreversible. Once a chemical change happens, there is no going back. At least not very easily. Can you think of any other examples of chemical changes? Pause the video here and jot down some examples in your guided notes. All right, let's say we try the baking show once again. What kinds of physical and chemical changes do you think will happen once we start baking some cupcakes? First, I have to mix together my dry ingredients. To the flour, I'm going to add salt and baking powder, and I'm going to mix them all together. Do you think this is a physical change or a chemical change? It's a physical change. None of the ingredients have changed identity, they're just in a new form. Okay, so next. My recipe says to crack two eggs. Is cracking an egg a physical or chemical change? If you said a physical change, you're right. I have definitely changed the form of the egg, but no new substances have been made. Now I've mixed my ingredients together, and these cupcakes are headed for the oven. Do you think baking the cupcakes is a physical change or a chemical change? It's a chemical change. If we observe, we can see several of the signs of a chemical change. The color of the batter is changing, turning into a beautiful golden brown. Gas bubbles are being produced, which is what causes the cupcakes to rise and get nice and fluffy. And that delightful aroma speaks for itself. Mmm, science is delicious. Let's recap what we've learned today. All changes that can happen to matter can be described as either physical or chemical. A physical change will change the form of the matter, but not its identity. And a chemical change will create new substances and change the identity of the matter itself. To find out more about physical and chemical changes of matter, be sure to check out the practice questions and activities for this lesson. All right, I'm gonna go study those cupcakes a bit more. So until next time, remember, science is all around us. See ya!